Wow, look at that neon sign. I forget your name.
Prepárense porque el pronóstico del tiempo avisa. La acción se apoderará del cine más cercano en julio con la llegada de Tornados. La nueva película de Warner Bros. Es un nuevo capítulo del clásico Tornado de 1996, producida por los mismos detrás de Indiana Jones y Jurassic Park. Dirigida por Lee Isaac Chung, el hombre detrás de la aclamada película nominada al Oscar Minari, Tornados presenta a nuestros favoritos del momento, Daisy Edgar Jones y Glenn Powell. Ellos interpretan a Kate Cooper y Tyler Owens, dos opuestos que se unen para intentar prever y dominar el poder de los tornados. El elenco estelar también cuenta con Anthony Ramos como Javi.
Stay tuned. It's gonna get dramatic.
That was really well timed.
We gotta go, we gotta go! Sit!
Y así, sin spoilear mucho, la temporada de tormenta se vuelve aún más loca con fenómenos aterradores y los protagonistas se encuentran en medio de varios tornados en Oklahoma. Créanme, habrá acción por todos lados. Y adivinen quiénes pudimos platicar con estos increíbles actores sobre este lanzamiento. Claro, mi amiga Valentina Pulgarín, presentadora de Warner Channel Brasil y su servidora. Así que abróchense los cinturones que estamos a punto de entrar a esta gran aventura. Yo soy Gaby Cam y esto es Inside Warner Tornados.
I'm sorry for what happened. You know a tornado rating. It's not based on size and wind speed.
I've got it, UK!
It's based on damage. What it destroys, what it takes from us.
At first, how surprised were you when you heard that this movie wasn't going to be shot in a soundstage, but yes, in Oklahoma during tornado season and all that?
I mean, I was so thrilled. I was so curious as to how they were going to achieve it all, you know, how they were going to make it look like we were truly chasing. But it was so amazing to be able to film in Oklahoma and, like, actually be out there in storm, you know, in tornado season while there were tornadoes touching down. And, you know, it really made it feel like we were truly chasing. Like, we were out there with windstorms, rainstorms, and we had a whole set be blown away. I mean, it was definitely challenging. Like, it was a miracle we made each day, truly. But yeah, what a cool thing, like, to be there and immerse ourselves.
How did you make sure that your reactions were accurate and that everything you were saying was accurate, despite maybe not being up close to a tornado?
Yeah, I mean, that was maybe one of the most challenging things, was how to, like, spiel off the jargon in a way that sounded like you knew what you were talking about. But we had a lot of, like, really brilliant consultants and meteorologists on set who were there to kind of guide us, which was really helpful. But yeah, I mean, the kind of exciting thing to be a part of this film is, like, obviously when we were filming it, we weren't really looking at actual tornadoes. So it's so cool to see what they look like in post, and that our genuine scared reactions actually aren't too big. They are genuinely scary. But my favorite part of being an actor is how much you get to learn about a subject you might have, like, otherwise dived into. So I love, like, looking at clouds now and being able to be like, also keep the numbers.
She's definitely the top student of the entire cast. She showed up to the National Weather Center with, like, notebooks and she pre-studied for the test. I mean, she knew what she was talking about. And Daisy's also one of the most curious people I've ever met. You didn't just become, like, a storm chaser on screen. You became fully certified. If there's some sort of badge, she got it.
Extreme weather is only getting worse. I want to help people, and you're the only one to get me close enough to a tornado to do it.
I don't chase anymore.
En la película, Daisy Edgar Jones interpreta a Kate Cooper, una ex cazadora de tormentas que ahora estudia patrones meteorológicos en Nueva York. Y toda su vida cambia cuando su amigo Javi, interpretado por Anthony Ramos, la llama para probar un sistema de rastreo de tormentas súper moderno en una semana donde el pronóstico del tiempo promete muchos tornados, lo cual atrae a curiosos y científicos de todos lados hacia Oklahoma. Es ahí donde conoce a Tyler Owens, interpretado por Glenn Powell, un influencer de las redes sociales que adora mostrar sus aventuras locas de caza tormentas con su equipo.
Once in a generation tornado outbreak continues.
You got quite the reputation, city girl. You thought you could destroy a tornado.
In theory, but I never had a chance to get close enough.
You want one?
Oh!
And Glenn, I know you actually got to work with real storm chasers. You all did. What did you get to learn from them, and how did you incorporate that on your character?
You know, tornadoes are sort of a mix of science, you know, and religion. You know, it's part what we know and part what we can't understand. And there's this, it's a very interesting phenomenon because you can predict these storms to a degree, and at a certain point it becomes instinct. So I think that's one of the fun parts about this movie that I think we capture, which is this idea of all these again, cowboy scientists, these people who really are so smart when it comes to the weather. And then there's this sort of gamification at the end where you have to, over the course of hundreds of miles, sometimes thousands, chase these storms to, you know, one direction or another. And I found that there was a real competitive, fun element. It's a real, I don't know, 30,000 foot chess match.
Tyler Owens calls himself a tornado wrangler.
If you feel it, chase it!
In the movie, Glenn, you have that line, "Hey kids, don't try this at home." I love that moment. I was wondering, what was something you had to do on set that was a big "don't try this at home" moment for you too?
We had to do some crazy stuff in this movie. One at the very end of the movie that I think threw us across Main Street in a pretty aggressive way. I think that was, that was a kids don't try this at home moment.
Do you think? Was dropped. Two garbage trucks full of it.
Yeah, pretty wild. But we had a great time. But there's a lot of these moments. I mean, when you go into to put audiences in the seat of what we're doing in Oklahoma, it has to feel visceral. It has to feel intense, and we have to kind of actually be doing it. So, we put our bodies on the line on this one.
And Anthony, obviously, the first film is such an instant classic, I would say. Was there something you were really eager to experience on set and kind of like see how it was like from the first film?
Yeah, I was just excited to be out there, you know, be out in the, you know, on set, be on location. You know, I was just glad that we weren't shooting on the stage. You know, you can easily shoot something like this on the stage. And, but I was just grateful that we were out there. We were in these fields. The weather was crazy. It was so hot. We were in the middle of tornado season. At any moment, we were like, yo, is the storm going to hit? We don't know. The wind's kind of blowing out of nowhere. What happened? It was just beautiful out. Like, every day was, you just didn't know what was going to happen, you know? And that, you know, I think that's what makes these experiences so special, really getting to just that unpredictability of, you know, you go to work and you're like, I don't know. I literally have no idea. All of a sudden the sky was green one day. I was like, how? I've never seen that in my life, you know, but I don't know. It just gets you into the movie. It gets you into the part a little bit more. And the cast is amazing. Our director too. So all of that.
We pull this off, it could help save thousands of lives. You don't face your fears, you ride them.
La película es una continuación del clásico de los años 90, dirigido por Jan de Bont, con Helen Hunt y Bill Paxton. ¿Sabían que eligieron filmar en Oklahoma porque el director Lee Isaac Chung es de la región? Por lo que la producción tiene un toque muy auténtico. Se puede sentir su amor por el lugar.
The once in a generation tornado outbreak continues.
It's so magic to be here filming Twisters. I'm a huge fan of the original, so I just kind of can't believe that we've dropped into this world.
Oh, she's perfect!
She's gorgeous!
The original Twister, when it came out, it meant a great deal to me because I was watching a film that took place around where I grew up. I grew up on a farm, and that terrain, that landscape, is a part of me.
Just another good day and good weather.
It's all about community, it's all about home, and it's all about this mutual love of the way everyone looks up at the sky with reverence and awe.
Anthony, tell me a little bit about living in that Oklahoma culture, because you were in 120 degrees on set. Besides the tornadoes, you were shooting there, engines blowing on you, eating the local food. How did that change how you approach your character on set?
It was good, you know, going line dancing and rodeos.
Nice.
All new things that I had never experienced, you know, and local food and kind of just, you know, getting to know people in town. You know, living in Oklahoma is very different than living in New York City or Miami, you know, so it was cool. It was really, really dope. And, you know, it helped a lot. It helped a lot with my characters just because I didn't grow up there. I didn't, you know, so it was just really nice just getting immersed in the culture and you know, being able to take that into the film.
It's truly about the community, which is such a lovely thing when you have, like, one of the things I love about watching this film is the shared love and obsession with this thing. And it's so cool to see a group of people united by something. And so for me, on my Super 8, I have, like, Glenn's terrified face while we were chasing. I'm joking, you were very brave. No, I am, like...
I cried once.
She cried once.
This is a film about science. It's about hope. It's about people trying to work together to solve problems. And it's also about revering and honoring, respecting, and loving nature.
We got twins! Twins!
Espero que hayan disfrutado este recorrido con nosotros a través de Tornados. No pierdan tiempo, corran ahora mismo a comprar sus entradas porque la película se estrena el 11 de julio. Ah, y manténganse atentos a las redes sociales de Warner Channel para no perderse nuestras novedades. Yo soy Gaby Cam y esto fue Inside Warner Tornados.
¿Has visto algo así?
Nunca. Es intensificado.